ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another episode of Cold Open here on Pastiche of Skin. Today, we are checking out Death Tales, the beta that's actually been set up on the PlayStation Network, and I haven't got to play it at all except for look at this single image, so let's get our asses in there and take a look. Game from Arcade Distillery, Prime Engine. This game is an open beta. Current gameplay and art is not in its final form. This is not yet my final form! Goku, come fight me in my final form. So what do we got here? I better actually turn the audio on, shouldn't I? Ah, there we go, so we can actually have it. So, Death Tales, directed by Luc Bernard. Luc Bernard? Luc Bernard, was that not the guy that did the, PETA game? A while back, the Kitten Squad? I'm curious about that. So this is actually a two-player game. I should have probably kept this for whenever, there's other people about. That immediately makes me go, this was a mobile game that's actually been put across. That makes me worried. Credits, Luc Bernard, one dude. Yeah, Luc Bernard. Driving by Luc Bernard. Okay, I'm sure it wasn't just by Luc Bernard. I think there's plenty of other people in it. Created in Lua. All right, let's see. We're going to jump straight into this game and give it a quick try. So one player, Death Tales. What do we got? What do you got for us? Show me the death. Okay, what's this? The Warther.
Sense a powerful essence trapped in the body, sick with fever. You will find it.
Okay. Okay, I'm starting to get a little bit worried about the audio here, because essentially whenever I'm not talking, the audio is going up and then warping itself back down again because of the gas ducker that we're currently running.
But we sense a powerful essence trapped in a body sick with fever. Will you find it? Return with the soul and you will be rewarded.
Well, that makes sense. Okay, so essentially we're given a quest there and I can go and chase it down. So obviously I've got ordinary attacks I can use. I don't think I've actually got anything done yet. Missing headwear. Okay, Gentleman Frog has asked. Yeah, he's lost his frog. Lost his headwear. Let's take a look to see what it is. The well-dressed frog seems deeply troubled.
Oh, tragic fate, as you know, one can hardly be a figure of high standing and without a fine hat. Alas, mine's has gone missing, and I need you to find it. The last time I remember seeing it, I was preparing to take a swim in a pond in the great forest. It wouldn't do that all to go swimming with a fine hat on, would it? So obviously, I must have removed it before jumping in and left it behind. Oh, I feel as though a part of me has been swept away and lost forever. So will you please find it? I simply cannot be seen about town like this. Imagine the scandal. Perhaps if you're not busy, I could impeach you to look for it. I will reward you handsomely for it. Why, thank you very much. Oh, that's delightful.
All right, so, whoa, what was that? I don't even know what that was. So, I don't know where I'm meant to be going in any way, shape, or form. Obviously, Moose, I'm going to the forest, aren't I? Yeah? Okay, so that's Mark 1. Or Missing Headwear. I think I'm going to go and reap a soul. I'll reap some poor lady's soul instead. So obviously with it being an open beta, this game looks kind of gorgeous. I like the idea. I've got this weird kind of... Whoa! Okay, obviously I beat the crap out of that, so I survived. Let's see if this is actually going to be effective as well. Oh, same thing, just beat the thing in the head. Yep. Yep, yeah, that's great. Enjoy that. Enjoy getting hit. I think I'm actually not meant to be floating like that, but... Oh, death from above, that was very effective. So I'm assuming I actually have combinations of things I can do to attack. So if I hit backwards and then push back the other way, yeah... Death from above? Do I get death from above again? Boom! That was what it was. Yeah! So I said you do combos with different directions and different buttons that actually attack. So, this just got me really feeling like it's almost like Odin Sphere slash... Oh! That guy hit me pretty hard. Am I dead? Where'd I go? Oh, there I am. Okay, so I'm gonna need to use some spell magic here, so on. Yeah? I don't know what I was doing. Hang on. Do I have any more? Oh, that killed him anyways. We're all good. I don't even know if I actually... Was that mist caused by me killing it or throwing ice or something at him? Nah, I think it's just the world itself. Alright, I don't have any magic to use, do I? I just don't even know if I do. Oh! Die! So it seems like combos start whenever you're facing one direction, so it's kind of hard to switch back and forth between them. That seems to be the way to go. So he's gotten like an aerial rave, and then you can actually do like death from above. And I'm dead. So, that's actually feared to be the picture of death that actually killed me as well. That's kind of weird. Okay, so essentially this section just keeps repeating until I actually complete it. Okay, well, essentially I consider it like a level, I suppose. Alright, so I get it now. So I said you have to combo my way to freedom and victory. Yeah, that was effective. So I know if I hold up and I press down, I actually have a series of combos I can use. Which is damn useful. And I'm going to fly upwards. Do I fly upwards with this one? No, I actually didn't. I already was in the air. Never mind. Ah, damn it. So that's going to give me spells. So I'm trying to figure out if I can actually heal myself. Do I have a way to heal myself? Oh, shit. I'm gonna die. I have no idea what I'm doing. And I'm dead. And I'm dead. So I'm not really getting what's going on here, other than the fact that I'm just getting myself beat into the ground over and over again. So maybe if I just try, I'm going to try and run past some of these enemies instead of actually attack. Oh, they attack as soon as you get in view. Yep, keep on moving. Keep on moving. Don't stop. Don't stop. Don't let them actually start hitting you. Yep, yep. Oh, shit, they're following me. That's not a good sign. Right, keep on moving. Come on, get out of the way. There we go. And you too, wizard boy. Bye-bye. And the wizard bitch. Well, they don't want to actually get in the way. Oh, no, get out of the way. Get out of the way! Ah! There we go. This is my opportunity to actually get down here and get some health back, maybe? I don't know. Do I actually have magic? Do I actually use the magic? No? No, that doesn't make sense. Oh! Dude, I got killed by the wee tiny thing now that time. Alright. I'm not really getting this just yet. I mean, essentially, I can understand that this is meant to be the R buttons and L buttons of attack. So, oh, right. So that's how you summon magic. Okay. So if I do this and... Right. So if I do that, I can actually summon big spells. And I get back some magic and some health for each one of those. Alright, that's enough to actually do that. Cool. Helpful. Alright, as long as I can remember, I can actually just keep spamming the shit out of that spell. How do I do the combo? How do I get myself to go up? Ah, damn it, I wanted to go up there, but sadly not happening. Alright, so if I use what? This? There we go, that got a little bit of it back. Alright, so I've got enough fireball power to actually be able to take out a couple of our big guys. So I'm starting to figure out how the spells work, and now I know actually how to survive! Ha 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 ha, fuckers! Oh! What, is that all you? Is that all you got?
Give me your health!
So essentially it's encouraging you to build up combos. Ah, now we find the lady to talk to. A worried woman stands over an infant boy, coughing and writhing in its crib. As you approach the giant child, his mother becomes aware of your presence. You, wait, don't take my son. I beg you, take me instead. You have a choice in front of you. Whose soul have you chosen to claim? Mother or child? Mother can sire more children. A mother always wants to die before her child. Essentially, this will be the mean choice. And this will be the actual kind of like meaner choice, I suppose, in a way, because the child hasn't had a life to live. What would you personally think? Like, personally, I would actually go, the mother would always want to die for her child, but who's going to raise the child when the mother is gone? That's the question. Like, do you leave the child to its own devices where it'll probably die of its own accord, or the mother who can actually, but it could very well possibly die from grief or take her own life in sadness, or would be angry and seek revenge for you not saving her child. I mean, this is a moral dilemma. A dilemma and a half. But I'm going to make it easy and pick the child. The infant's body stiffens and he cries out softly as you claim his soul. His mother collapses to the floor next to the crib, sobbing. I feel horrible! Here's your goddamn soul! You offer the child's soul to the Grim Reaper. Ah, the soul of a child. See how it shines, unblemished by the many sins of a long life. And the mortals only see a tragedy. We accept your offer, Reaper. Okay. So that's the only quest I can do with him? Okay. Are you serious? Oh man, I had to sit and do. I'm not cool with that. Since you sent me on the same quest over and over again, I suppose this makes sense because it's essentially part of the fact that this is an open beta and there's not that many levels to do. But at least we get to see some variety by doing this other level. I think the magic's a little bit OP. Oh, this is interesting. How do I meant to do that? Oh, man, how do I glide? Do I have a magic spell? Oh, no, there was actually not that. Ah, damn, I don't have any magic left. Hup-bah! Oh, shit! I'm gonna get my ass beat there. So I have to jump up here and get around before... It's like, that's a terrible way to actually put that in the position. It's very, very frustrating. Right, it's really hard to see some of these platforms. Yeah, I'm dead. I figured I was gonna be dead there. It took a while for me to actually be recognized as being dead. Okay. I'm not a big fan of those red buttons. I'm worried about these kind of like different... I don't know what things actually affect me. Oh, you fuck. Ah! Damn it. Did this level just change layout? Like, how did I respawn in a randomly generating world? I don't know how I'm going to survive this! Ah! Nope. It's weird. The world actually did change. I'm okay with that. Oh, I get it. So there actually is going to be items that are going to be blocked in the way. I get it now. Ah, you ice wizard bastards! No! Oh, I'm dead! I'm so dead! I'm trapped! I'm dead! I knew that was gonna happen. So I need to stop depending on my fireballs, because that's not gonna work. See, you learn a new lesson every round. Ah! Stop you and your fireballs! Okay, come on, we're going to get this now. I'm just the fact that I'm actually worried about not surviving this, and then I'm getting so focused on the fact that I can't barely, I'm actually finding it difficult to actually keep talking while playing, which is then affecting the audio from the game, because the game's actually so loud, and I don't want to actually turn it off. Oh, man. Like, the fact that these levels keep changing is a little bit unnerving. Alright, fucking... Yes, got him in midair, and I still managed to survive. Happy days. Right, oh, jeez. It's like running through Mario levels. There we go, I survived that, thankfully enough. Oh, there we go. Oh, I'm not gonna make it. Oh, Jesus. No, I'm getting a little bit frustrated with this game now, and I'm worried that I'm actually not gonna be able to make it to the end of the level without losing my shit. Okay, let's see. We're gonna make it. We're gonna give this another try. We're gonna at least do each of these missions once. That's what the intention is. I'm assuming this is back to the way it was the first time I played it, is it? Oh, no, the map's still completely different. So what do I do here? Oh, I can climb up. Oh, what? Just wood chips? Okay. Oh, I'm gonna be able to get that. Hang on. Okay. Can't climb up any further. Boom, at least I got that one. No. Oh, so many explosions. So many explosions. You fucker, come here. Alright, come on, wizard boy. I like the fact that I can just take him out with one of those. Oh, that was just gratifying. Right, come on. We can do this. We got this. We got this. Springboarding them to fuck. Boom. Alright, we got you. Got him. Alright, so we're moving on. We're almost to the end, I'm sure. We're almost there. Keep on fighting. Keep on going. Okay. I think we're going to actually make it to the end of this level this time again. I'm glad I actually made it through. Oh, no! Oh, collision detection for that fall was actually a little bit cheesy. Alright, this is a different enemy type I haven't seen before. Alright, I'm gonna kill this guy before we actually talk to the story player. Right, bam, there we go, we got the beginning of the...
Please don't hurt me. I was taking a swim with my papa, and then the next thing I knew, he was gone. Could you help me find him? He looks like me, only bigger, and he dresses really well. I'm sure he would be grateful.
So essentially, is this his son's hat? That's a little bit surreal.
My hat is my son. My son is my hat. The young frog bounds over to Sir Grenouille.
Grenouille?
Papa!
Oh, my dear lad, Chesterfield, what nonsense have you gotten yourself up to? And have you seen my hat?
You left me behind at the pond, not your hat. I could have starved to death if there wasn't for this person. You've been like this ever since I was a bollywog.
Oh, well, apology? Yes, of course, I forgive you, Chesterfield. And you, I'm terribly sorry about how my son is interrupting your search. Now, here's a little something for your trouble. I'll try to retrace my steps and figure out where else I might have left it. Where else I might have left that hat, even.
Well, thank you very much. Yeah, this is interesting. So, essentially, there's three... the two guys in Vestilia here, and then Solus is a place I haven't been, so I have no one to do there. So it just shows two people that I have the quest with at the moment, and it's the same two people, and it's the same two quests I'll be doing. So, yeah, this must be just the open beta content, just to test out and show the method of the game. It's wonderfully crazy. The character designs are interesting. I like the artwork. The combat is a bit unrefined, is probably the best way to describe it, and I'm enjoying looking at this game. I wouldn't mind seeing more of it. But, yeah, like I said, this is a open beta for Death Tales from Luc Bernard. And, It looks fun. I could get into this. I could definitely get into this. I'm imagining this with no voice acting. If he's looking for a voice actor, I would happily play Gerald. You know, it's as long as I can just give Chesterfield a good little slap out of occasion. It would be absolutely fabulous. Yes. So, yeah, guys, this has been Death's Tale on the PlayStation Network and open beta, and I hope you guys enjoyed me playing through it, and I hope you guys enjoyed the stuff here on the channel. If you enjoyed what I was talking about, you enjoyed hearing about this game, then you can always feel free to actually just hit the subscribe button way up here at the top of the screen, and it'll allow you to actually see videos as they come out here on the channel. And if you press over here, they'll actually see other episodes of Cold Open or Free Play Fridays or any other series that's actually available. There'll be a couple of playlists, a video that's actually very recently put up on the channel, and a personal recommendation from me to you based on your YouTube search results. So if there's things that you actually looked at before on the channel, this will be the one closest to what you would like out of this channel. So if you caught this episode by randomness, this is the one that you're probably meant to be seeing here on the channel. So I hope you guys enjoyed, and I hope to see all you dudes in the next video. Bye.